Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Amen. Thank God.
Let it go. Thank you. So first, I'm giving honor to God and to Prophet Jones and to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Well, I would like to first thank God for saving me and filling me up with the Holy Ghost. And around this time last year, I never figured that God allowed me to be healed from COVID around this time last year. And also, I remember we were in service. We had the revival a few weeks ago. And in the revival, Prophet Jones, he had prophesied that he said, for those of you that may be needing, you know, a new running vehicle, he said to praise God. And we all praise God, as Prophet has said, through the Holy Spirit. And the other week, my previous vehicle just completely stopped on me. And so God blessed us to where we could get a new vehicle with zero down.
Amen.
And they even paid for the insurance as well,
Amen.
Which was a great blessing.
Amen.
And I'm thankful to God for that. And God also had, you know, put in Prophet Jones' spirit a while back ago about people wanting to work from home, which it had already happened beginning in January. But I thought about it because I had been praying to God for a work from home job for a long time. And like times before, you know, some work from home jobs, they weren't legit as they said they were. But this job, it was a legit job, and I thank God for that as well. And if you all would like to share your testimonies as well, you're more than welcome to do so. I give honor unto the men of the house and First Lady Jones and all the saints in the house. I want to testify of God's goodness. I thank God, you know, throughout the COVID when it first struck, for allowing me to be sustained with me and my family, allowing for us to still have income, transportation. I thank God for allowing me to keep my job. I know that there were several that couldn't. They were laid off. People that were no longer needed their jobs due to the circumstances, but I thank God for keeping me. I also thank God for the health of my family, my health, my strength. I thank God for continuously blessing me and my family. That is my testimony.
Amen. Let's give the Lord a great big hand clap.
Amen.
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 And I will again like to give honor to God to Prophet Jones and to my brothers and sisters in Christ. I wanted to go over Proverbs 16. Proverbs 16, and I'm going in the Amplified Version. And Proverbs 16 and verse 1, it says, "The plans and reflections of the heart belong to man, but the wise answer of the tongue is from the Lord. All the ways of a man are clean and innocent in his own eyes, and he may see nothing wrong with his actions. But the Lord weighs and examines the motives and intent of the heart and knows the truth. Commit your works to the Lord, submit and trust them to him, and your plans will succeed if you respond to his will and guidance. And the Lord has made everything for his own purpose, even the wicked, according to the role for the day of evil. Everyone who is proud and arrogant in heart is disgusting and exceedingly offensive to the Lord. Be assured he will not go unpunished. By mercy and love and kindness and truth, not superficial ritual, wickedness is cleansed from the heart. And by the fear of the Lord, one avoids evil. When a man's ways please the Lord, he makes even his enemies to be at peace with him." And for some reason, I was reminded of this dream that I had. And the vehicle that had stopped on me, I actually seen that vehicle in my dream. And I seen someone trying to steal that van in my dream. And so, like, sometimes, you know, like, people that are wicked, like, sometimes, for example, like, there will be prophecies that have been prophesied over your life. And, you know, they'll try to change it up. You know, but, you know, God, he's not going to let that happen. He's definitely not going to let that happen, especially when, you know, you're right before him. And, you know, like, no matter what word curses or timely curses, like, I've literally heard people, like, try to speak word curses in my face, but I will go back and rebuke and bind it. And they'll say, "Well, I see in this amount of time this is going to happen," and I rebuke and bind it right then and there and say, "No, the devil is a lie." They'll say, "By this time, you're not going to make it." And I'll be like, "No, the devil is a lie." I go back and pray about it to God because I know that if God done told me something, you know, he's going to do just what he told me he's going to do. You know, if he said that this person is made to be in your corner, but it's people around you or surrounded by you trying to say, "No, this person is against you," but you know good and well that God done said, "No, this person is for you. They're praying for you to succeed in life. They're not trying to deter you." But, you know, like, the devil, he'll try to come and distract you. He certainly will. Like, the scripture reminds us that the devil's mission is to steal, kill, and destroy. You know, but God, he comes to give us life and that more abundantly. He's not going to try and tell you that, you know, go and kill yourself. God's not going to tell you to do that. It's not what you're going to do. I see people on the news, they'll say, "Well, the reason why I killed my child is because God told you to do that." God did not tell you to kill your child. That's not what he told you to do. He told you to, you know, nurture your children. He told you to, you know, take care of your children, just as he said in his word, you know, for example. And as I was saying again, you know, God, he has a divine purpose for each and every one of us. You know, as Sister Deetra, she's a nurse. You know, like, you know, I can't be a nurse. You know, that's not even my lane. I'm scared of even getting needles in my arm. Like, that's not my lane, you know. Sister Brianna, she can do some hair like no other. If you tell me to do hair, you're gonna be messed up. And you know, I'm thankful to God, you know, that each of us, you know, we are all in this thing together called life. And each of us in this room together has been with us through, like, literally thick and thin. And I'm thankful to God that God has allowed us to see that everyone in this room, God has predestined us already. you know, that we're in this thing together, you know. And I'm thankful to God for each and every one of you again, because I remember, you know, and with that being said, when I was in my sick bed, each and every one of you in this room were checking on me, were calling on me, asking how Jazz doing. You know, is she doing good? Like, tell the doctors, like, what does this medicine do? Or, no, this medicine, you know, that's not good. Like, I remember Sister Deidre, Prophetess Deidre, she would say, no, tell them, no, you cannot take that medicine, you know. Or, yeah, you can take the medicine. That should be good for you. Like, I appreciate that, you know. I appreciate Prophetess Brianna, my husband, Prophet Jones, everyone in this entire room, you know, all coming together, you know, touching and agreeing together in Jesus' name, you know, because we're all in this thing together. You know, no jealousy of anyone, you know, we all in this together. And I thank God for that, you know, just reminding me that, you know, there's no little eyes, no little ewes, you know, because the head, the eyes, the arms, the feet, you know, we're all a part of this, you know, this thing here called life. One body, one Lord, one faith, one baptism. We thank God for you all, and I thank you, God, again for this union, this fellowship in Jesus' name. And Prophetess Brianna, you would like to share a word with us?
In the book of 1 Samuel, the second chapter, I'll be reading verses 1 to 10. And it reads, "Then Hannah prayed, my heart rejoices in the Lord. The Lord has made me strong. Now I have an answer for my enemies. I rejoice because you rescued me. No one is holy like the Lord. There is no one besides you. There is no rock like our God. Stop acting so proud and haughty. Don't speak with such arrogance. For the Lord is God, who knows what you have done. He will judge your actions. The bow of the mighty is now broken, and those who stumbled are now strong. Those who were well fed are now starving. Those who were starving are now full. The childless woman now has 7 children, and the woman with many children wastes away. The Lord gives both death and life. He brings them down to the grave, but raises others up. The Lord makes some poor and others rich. He brings some down and lifts others up. He lifts the poor from the dust and the needy from the garbage dump. He sets them among princes, placing them in seats of honor. For all the earth is the Lord's, and he has set the world in order. He will protect his faithful ones, but the wicked will disappear in darkness. No one will succeed by strength alone. Those who fight against the Lord will be shattered. He thunders against them from heaven. The Lord judges throughout the earth. He gives power to his king. He increases the strength of his anointed one." Amen. I thank God for his word first and foremost, but this particular passage alongside with the chapter itself speaks to me personally. When I was going through a period of time where I felt really down, I was depressed, I was going through in my mind, I felt as though the enemy was provoking me continuously. I would be online, and social media, I believe, in this day and time, could be the worst thing for you to be on looking onto, because you have things that kind of influence you and that kind of can mess with your thoughts, and that's what was happening for me in particular. I felt as though nobody wanted me. I felt unwanted. I felt less than. I didn't feel worthy. So that's why I compared with Hannah, because Hannah was provoked by her enemy, because her enemy had something that she didn't. But in this particular passage, and it brought tears to my eyes when I read it, is because you go through a stage where you're down, but God will bring you up. You go through a period of time where things may seem as though it's not there, but God will bring it to you. So I thank God for his word, and I want to encourage those to don't look at the lives of others. You don't know what people are really going through. You don't know what's happening behind the smiles of these pictures and these posts. You don't know what's happening behind the statuses that people post about when they're bragging about the things that they have or they're telling you what they have. You don't know what it took for them to get it. You don't know who they borrowed it from, if it even really belongs to them. But I thank God for this word because it encourages me, and I hope it encourages you all. And that is all that I have.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Amen.
Love. Oh,
Father God, for, amen, that beautiful selection. And we're getting ready, amen, glory to God. Anyone that needs prayer, amen, anyone needs prayer, amen, come on up. Amen, glory to God, because we want to pray, amen, and we want to believe God. Amen, there is nothing too hard for the Lord, amen.
Fulfill
sacerdocio. La talla de la corrige de la corrige de la Se le me corrige de la corrige de la corrige. La talla la verdad de la corrige de la corrige. In the name of Jesus. Oh, la talla de la corrige de la corrige. Oh, ven de la corrige. God, let them have that help. Low blood pressure, hurt, deep hurt, rejection, the spirit of rejection, the spirit of fear, the spirit of intimidation, the spirit of hurt, the spirit of low self-esteem. We speak, Lord and God, that there will be the head and not the tail, above and not beneath. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus.
People that was jealous of her. La Taya Labaha.
we counseling. Every sound, we speak peace. We speak peace. We speak peace. La taya, let the fire of God burn down on us. Glory to God, everything, glory to God, that's not like you. There it go. Peace, 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 peace. He can't hold a little shit. Every stronghold of hurt, every stronghold of rejection, every stronghold of disappointment, we counsel. Vata, then of a hope, then of a hope, then of a hope, then of a hope, then of a hope. Fire, yet of a whole shot. Let your Holy Spirit, Lord and God, come in like never before. Release, Lord and God, the man of God. Lord and God, move. Quickly, you come, oh shit. Yes, God. Yata. La taya of a hope. I speak strength to her heart. I speak strength to her heart. She will not give up. She will not be weary. She will not faint. She will not fold under pressure. But she will stand tall. Zata, lata. Stand tall. Strength, 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 strength. Perfect peace. Lata yala bahoshi. Thank you, God. Hayala bahoshi. Send the help, God. Haya. Yes, God. Send the help, God. She's been praying, God, for glory to God, a new place. Glory to God, she's been praying. Glory to God, for you, glory to God, to increase, glory to God. Glory to God, things, glory to God, in her life. I thank you, God, for prosperity being on her. I thank you, God, for sending the right people around them. Oh, God. La tire of a whole shit. In the name of Jesus. Please, I want y'all to hold y'all stomachs. Vatire of a whole shit. Venom of a whole shit. Father, in the name of Jesus, everything that's not like you in their stomachs, I command for it to let them go. Now. 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 La taya la bataya la boho. Vele le le ko le ke le lo shi ke vele le lo shi. La taya la bataya le lo shi e vele. Le le boho shi ke mana le 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 lo shi ke vele lo. La taya la bataya le le lo ko le ke le lo shi. Ye le 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 lo shi. La taya la baha. The fire of God. Thank you.
I feel things breaking.
is breaking. It's breaking. It's breaking. It's breaking. Oh, shut up. Yeah,